A method is a program module that contains a series of statements that allow a task to be carried out. We have been working with methods for a while through using our main method in all of our programs. And that main method is the one that automatically executes whenever we run a program. We do a lot of stuff inside of that method throughout our course. So you can see that there's quite a bit of things that can be accomplished inside of methods. Whenever you execute a method, you invoke or you call that method. You can call it from the same file that you're currently working in, or you can also call it from another class file, which we'll begin working with shortly. Any program can have however many number of methods that it needs, and each method can be called however many times it needs to be called. I compared the usage of methods into a warp room in Mario. So if you think of the main world as your main class, you can warp to the other pieces of the game and get additional coins or extra lives or whatever you need to do, but then you return back to the world that you are in. So if we consider Mario with our Java program, what we'll have is this main world being our main method, and whenever we get ready to execute our methods, we'll go down the warp tunnel, we'll do whatever the method does, and after it's done, we'll take whatever we gain or lose during that method run back to our main game. So if we take this particular program, you'll see it's called Say Hello. It's got a public static void main, which is our main method. And we print out a line, welcome to the program. Here we are calling say howdy. And say howdy is a method inside of the say hello class, but it's down here. And whenever we make this call to this method, we come down here and we run and we do whatever's inside of say howdy. After this method is done running, it comes back up here to where it was originally called, and we continue on with our main program. So if you think about this in terms of Mario, the say hello, the public static main, here's our comparison to the world that we're currently in. Whenever we call our say hello or say howdy, we are going down into our warp room where we can get some extra coins. In this case, we're just going down here to our say howdy method and doing whatever we're going to be doing. And once we're done with our say howdy method, we are returning up the pipe and continuing on with our program. With several different parts of a method that you need to become familiar with, the first line of our method is our access modifier. Typically it's public, so that means anything can access it and anything can call it. Next we have a return type or a void. So this is the type or the thing that you're getting back from the method. Now each method can only return one thing. So it might be a string, it might be an int, it might be a double, or it might be a boolean, or it might be of an object type, which we will work with those in a couple weeks. Sometimes we don't need a return type, sometimes we just need something to happen, and that is called a void method. It doesn't return anything, it just does something. Next in our method signature line, we have a method name. Typically, the method name is all lowercase, except for if there are any additional words, it is that word is uppercase. Then we have parentheses, and inside those parentheses are called parameters. And those are things that the method takes and uses in its execution of the method. We don't have to have parameters. There'll be some cases where we don't. We have a method body, and that is in between the two curly brackets, and that contains the implementation or the task that are carried out in completion of the method. Finally, if there's a return type, there will be a return statement. The last line of our methods are typically return unless it's a void method, and then there is no return type. So if we take a look at this method, it is a public method. It means anybody, any program can call it. The return type is a string, and the name of the message is the name of the method is compose message, and it takes two parameters, a string and an int. Inside of this method, it creates a string called message. It's empty to begin with, and then we add to message the words hello plus whatever they passed in for n, your, and then whatever they passed in for A, years old. And then we're just returning the string. So you'll notice that the string message and the return type message matches to our method signature line. Here's another example. It's a public method. The return type is a void, meaning that it doesn't return anything. The name of the method is a paint component, and it takes a graphics parameter that will be called G locally. Inside of this method, it does several things to this graphics. Sets color, fills the oval, sets the color, draws the oval, but it doesn't return anything, so it just does something. And once this, all these lines inside of this method are done executing, it returns back to where this method was originally called. When you use a method in a program, you have to know three things. You have to know the name of the called method, the type of information to send to the method, and the type of data that will be returned from the method. When you need to share data between the main program and the method, it's called passing a parameter. And the method receives the item. It might do stuff to it, it might return a value, might save it to a database. It's hard to say exactly what it'll do depending on the method. But the way that you get information between programs, or between the main program and the method, is by using a parameter. And those are the things inside of the parentheses. So in this example, we have public int total. It's a public method, returns an int, it is called total, and takes an int a as a parameter. So it's going to take in an integer as the parameter, and it's going to refer to that integer as a throughout the little mini program, or throughout the method run. This program creates a new int variable called new value. It adds 10 to the value that's passed in from the parameter, and then it returns new value from the method whenever it is done. The parameters are going to have not only the data type, an int, a double, a string, maybe it's of an object type, but it's also going to have a name that we refer to it locally inside of the method. So it's just like declaring and initializing a variable in our main program. It's just done a little differently because we're not actually initializing it whenever we create the method. We initialize it whenever the method is called and it's passed in. Methods can have multiple parameters. They list the arguments within the method called, so within the parentheses, and they're separated by commas. We have a data type and a local identifier, or a local variable name, for each parameter. If we have multiple parameters that have the same data type, the data type must be repeated with the temporary name that it's called within the method. Here's another example. This one takes four parameters, an int, and two color objects, color C and color C2, does some things to those with those colors and with those X and Y values, and then it repaints. So actually this is an example of a method that calls another method. Again, the return type is a void, so we're not sending anything back to the place where this method was originally called. As you've seen earlier, part of the great things about using methods is that we can return a value to use with our program. The return type for the method tells you what kind of data type the value that the method will send back. It can be any type, so it could be a string, an int, a double. It could also be of a particular object, so maybe you have a bank account or a cash register or something like that. It can pass back objects as well. It is listed in front of the method name when the method is defined. So you'll have to decide right away if this method is going to return something and what type or object is it going to return. And as you saw earlier, methods can also return nothing. They can just have a return type of void, and that just means it does stuff, but it doesn't return any value back to the place where it was originally called. Here's a couple examples on ways that we can return a value to the place where it was called. So let's say I have an example method called getHoursWorked. It is public, and it returns an int. Now normally the reason that you are calling this method is so that you can use it again. So you don't necessarily have to do it. You could just not use it, not store it. But typically if you're going to go to the work to call the method, you're probably going to use the return value from it. Now you can store that variable inside of an integer variable of the same type. So in this case, if getHoursWorked, since it returns an int, our variable that we're going to store the result in will be an int. We can also use the results from a method without storing it directly. So if you look at the last line here, we're going to print out the hours worked and then the plus sign, and then we just call the method. And whatever value comes back from get hours worked will be printed inside of that print line statement. Whenever I'm ready to call methods, I have three key things that I have to plan for. I have to know the method name, and I need to know if I have any parameters that I have to pass in, and I need to know how I'm going to handle the return. So those are all three important things that you'll need to know and plan for whenever you're ready to call methods. Looking at these as an example, public string get book string ISBN. So I know that I'm going to have a string returned from this method. The method's name is getBook, and I'm going to need to be passing a string that's going to be treated as the ISBN inside of this method. This method might take the string that's passed in as the ISBN, look it up in a database, grab the string for the book name, and store that into a string that be returned whenever the method is done running. Public int compute area int l int w. So I know it takes two parameters. It's called compute area, and whenever I'm ready to use this method, I've got to pass in two int values, and I'll receive an int after it's done running. This method's name is called do something secret. It takes in three parameters, a string and two ints, and it doesn't have anything that it returns. It just simply does something, and then it returns control back to the main method. Now, as you get ready to create your methods the first time, we will be creating methods inside of the class that also holds our main method. Now, classes that hold the main method are special. We do not initialize objects off of them typically, but this is something we'll talk about in a few weeks. Because we don't initialize objects off of classes that have the main method, we have to use the keyword static in our methods inside of classes that have a main method. The signature line will now contain the access modifier, the keyword static, the return type, and the name of the method. In this example here, public static void say hi. We also need to be very mindful of our curly brackets whenever we're working with classes that have more than one method. Our public class is say hi, and we have our public static void main up here. And you'll see there's my opening and closing curly brackets for my public static void main. Now down here is my method. Because it is also in the same class that has a public static void main, I have my public static void say hello, and the number of times I'm going to say hello. So again, we have to match up our curly brackets. So our methods are encapsulated inside of curly brackets as well as our main method. And then we have one big set of curly brackets for our whole public class. Eclipse will help you with this. It'll tell you whenever you have too many or too few. Now that you're becoming familiar with some of the terminologies used in methods, let's jump into Eclipse and begin creating methods.